I'm praying God, let you shout hallelujah. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Whatever you are connected to us this morning, Lagos, Nigeria, other parts of Nigeria, America, Europe, all over the world, wherever you are connected to us this morning, I'd like you to raise up your two hands and give God seven wonderful hallelujah. I want to go. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. Let's put hands together for the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. Begin to appreciate the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He's the one that have made us to see this day. The songwriter say, when I see the breaking of another day, I say thank you. Lord, we appreciate you this morning. Glory be to your name. In the name of Jesus. Open your Bible to the book of Psalm 89. We want to read verse 1. Psalm 89 verse 1. I read, I will sing of the mercies of the Lord forever. With my mouth will I make known your faithfulness to all generations. Praise the Lord. The psalmist said he will sing of the mercies of the Lord of God. And with his mouth he will make known to generations your faithfulness. Lord, these are mouth of great mercy. This morning we want to open this psalm by singing unto the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the mercies of the Lord. In the name of Jesus. That particular scripture is a song. And it says, I go. So sing along with me. I will sing of the mercies of the Lord forever. I will sing of the mercies of the Lord with my mouth. With my mouth will I make known thy faithfulness. I will sing of the mercies of the Lord forever. I will sing of the mercies of the Lord with my mouth. With my mouth will I make known thy faithfulness, thy faithfulness with my mouth. Appreciate God for his mercy. Sing of the mercies of the Lord. This is a month of great mercy. Psalm 145 verse 8. He said the Lord is gracious. He is a compassionate God. He is slow to anger and is of great mercy. Thank, appreciate him for your mercy, for the mercy of God over you and your family this morning. In the name of Jesus Christ. Say, Lord, I thank you for your mercy over me, my spouse, my children, and all that partakes to us, O Lord. Our family members, Lord, we appreciate you for your mercy. Thank you because it's by your mercy that we are alive. It's by your mercy that the enemy has not snipped life out of us. It's by your mercy, oh God, that we are prevailing or we have prevailed over coronavirus.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus Christ, appreciate God for his mercy. Father. Say, Father God, I thank you. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your mercy. Glory be to your name, Father. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank God for your mercy this morning. Oh, thank you for your mercy. Lord, we appreciate you. Lord, we give you praise. Lord, we give you glory. In the name of Jesus. Blessed be your name, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Revelation 12:11 says, they overcame by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimonies. Ephesians 1:7 says, we are redeemed by the blood of Jesus. Colossians 1:14 says, we are redeemed by the blood of Jesus. Exodus 12:30 says, when I see that blood, I'll pass over you. Now open your mouth and begin to plead the blood of Jesus Christ upon you and your family members. Say, I soak myself, soak my spouse, soak my children with the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I lay hold on the blood of Jesus this morning for my victory. For my victory in every area of my life. Concerning my health, I lay hold on the blood of Jesus Christ. Concerning my ministry, I lay hold on the blood of Jesus Christ. Concerning my marriage, I lay hold on the blood of Jesus Christ. Concerning that challenge, whatever the challenge may be, the blood of Jesus is able. By the blood of Jesus, you are redeemed. You are redeemed. You are redeemed. You are redeemed. Say, I soak my foundation. I soak my foundation in the pool of the blood of Jesus. My foundation, drink the blood of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, anything that is not of God in my foundation, anything that does not glorify God in my life, by the blood of Jesus, I wash it up this morning. I wash them off. I wash them off. I wash them off. I wash them off. In the name of Jesus. Command the blood of Jesus to deliver you. There is deliverance in the blood of Jesus. That's why we always sing the song, Super Blood of Jesus. Come and deliver me. The blood that flows in Calvary. Come and deliver me. Super Blood of Jesus. Super Blood of Jesus. Come and deliver me. The blood of flows in Calvary. Come and deliver. Come and deliver. Come and deliver. Come and deliver. Come and say, blood of Jesus, deliver me. And my family members, in the name of Jesus. Blood of Jesus, preserve us. In the name of Jesus. Blood of Jesus, defend us. In the name of Jesus. Pray, 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 pray. In Jesus' name we are praying. Bible said Jesus Christ coming out from the water. He saw the heavens open upon him. And the Spirit of God descended upon him like a dove. And the voice came, thou art my beloved son, in whom I am well pleased. When the heavens are open, there are revelations. That revelation that you need to turn around your destiny for what God has proposed for you. We're going to pray this morning. I command the heavens over the service to open so that that word will come to you today. In the name of Jesus Christ. Point your finger to heavens now. Say, oh ye heavens, of this morning's service. Oh ye heavens, over my family. Oh ye heavens, over my family members. Open in the name of Jesus. Command the heavens to open. Command the heavens to open. Command the heavens to open. Our heavens must open. No power can shut our heavens. In the name of Jesus. Heavens of healing. Heavens of deliverance. Heavens of favor. Heavens of prosperity. Heavens of breakthroughs. Heavens of enlightenment. This is our year of enlightenment. I command the heavens of enlightenment to open upon you now. Heavens of increase. Heavens of opportunities. Heavens of new ideas. Open upon me and my family member this morning. In the name of Jesus. Open upon Clan Priestess and Lekki. Open upon all our members, home and abroad. In the name of Jesus. Heavens open. Heavens open. Heavens open. Heavens open. In Jesus' name we pray. That scripture, Matthew 3:16, where Jesus was coming out from the water and the heavens were open and the Spirit came upon him. We want to command the Holy Spirit to take control of this service this morning. Say, Holy Ghost fire,
Holy Ghost fire.
take control of this service. In the name of Jesus Christ, from the prevailing prayer to the praise and worship to the world redemption.
Yes.
Holy Ghost fire, take control. Holy Spirit, have your way. 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 In the name of Jesus, Holy Spirit, have your way, have your way, oh, in my life, have your way, oh, Holy Spirit, have your way, have your way, oh, in my life, have your way. Say power of God, say power of God, Spirit of living God, rest upon our parents in the Lord afresh, in the name of Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit of God, encourage them, even in this season, in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit of God, deliver our parents in the Lord from unfriendly friends, from the hands of the enemy, in the name of Jesus. Pray right now, even for our center pastor, that the hand of God will rest upon him in the name of Jesus. And all the ministers in Clam, prayers in Alekia and Clam worldwide, that the hand of God will rest upon us in the name of Jesus Christ. Pray that God will take control in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. By the time this crisis are over, we will take record and all of us will be complete. None of us will be missing this morning. Our parents, Lord, will not be missing. Their family members will not be missing. I said that pastors and their family members, all the ministers, none of us will be missing. By the power of God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Bible said, I will build my church and the gate of hell shall not prevail. Job 5, verse number 12 says, for he frustrated the devices of the crafty so that their hands cannot perform their enterprise. Want to pray this morning that the plan of the enemy to frustrate this service this morning will not prosper. In that it says, every plan of hell concerning this service this morning, you will not prosper. 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 In the name of Jesus. Pray that the plan of hell will fail. In the name of Jesus. Pray right now. By the power of God, every plan of hell, you will not prosper. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Say, light of God, kingdom of God, shine upon Clan President Lekki and Clan Global. In the name of Jesus Christ, light of God, kingdom of God, shine upon Clan.
Shine.
In the name of Jesus Christ, home and abroad. Home and abroad. In the name of Jesus, light of God, shine. Let darkness give way. Let darkness disappear from every area of our lives. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Command the light of God to shine. Let the light of God shine now. Light of God shine. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every hidden treasure, let the light of God shine upon it so that our eyes can see them. In the name of Jesus Christ. Let's pray for our leaders. Leaders all over the world. Let's pray for our president. Even our governors. That God will help them at this time. That God will give them the wisdom even to manage the crisis. Pray that evil will not befall them and their family members. In the mighty name of Jesus. 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 We pray for our nation Nigeria. This is our Jerusalem. We say, seek the peace of Jerusalem for you to prosper. Lord, we seek the peace of Nigeria. Let prosperity be our portion this morning. In the name of Jesus Christ. Finally, we want to pray for yourself this morning. We are taking the scripture from Psalm 81, verse number 10. I paraphrase it. What the scripture says, God is saying, open your mouth wide and I will fill it. So God is telling you this morning that you should open your mouth. It's a blank check God is giving you right now. Yes. Write your name there and fill in everything that you want God to do for you. Open your mouth and begin to pray now. Say, Father, this is my needs this time. In the name of Jesus Christ, the wisdom, the knowledge, the understanding that I need, oh God, to navigate these murky waters in the area of business, in the area of career. Oh Lord, reveal it to me. Reveal it to us, oh Lord. Reveal it to us, oh Lord. Reveal it to us, oh Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ. Pray for your spouse, pray for your children, home and abroad, that God will preserve them, that the enemy will not travel by you, in the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says, for by strength no man shall prevail. Ask God to strengthen you. Ask God to strengthen you, for you to prevail, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Begin to wave your hand to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Appreciate God now. Appreciate Him, for He is a good God. He is a wonderful Father. Appreciate Him. Appreciate Him. Lord, we appreciate you this morning. Thank you because we know you are here already. Glory be to your name, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Rapotele Brando Zikatolia. In the name of Jesus Christ. You are Yahweh. Hey, you are Yahweh. Come on, sing that song now. You are Yahweh. Hey, you are Yahweh. You are Yahweh. You are Yahweh. Alpha, Omega, you are Yahweh, you are Yahweh. Alpha, Omega, you are Yahweh, you are Yahweh.
Shama, Jehovah Nissi, Elohim. The Bible says in 1 Thessalonians 5:18, he said in everything, let's give thanks to him. Just wave your hands wherever you are. Say hallelujah to his name. Begin to appreciate him. Give him thanks. 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 Say thank you, Jesus. For me and my family, I am not going to say that to say thank you. Because you wash over us. You guide us. You protect us. You provide for us. Even in this time of pandemic, you guide us. You protect us. None of me and my family are infected. That's why I appreciate it. That's why I am blessed. Thank you, Jesus. As far as the heavens stand, stand above the earth, you are exalted. Oh, unlimited God. As far as far as the heavens stand, oh, stand above the earth. You are exalted, you are exalted. Unlimited God, unlimited. As far as the heaven, as far as the heavens stand, come and worship him. Stand above the earth. Mighty God, you are exalted, you are exalted. You are Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We are going to take it from the east this morning. Wherever you are, you can wave your white handkerchief. Just wave it. And praise God. I want you to dance. Wave your white handkerchief wherever you are. We are taking it from the east. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Are you ready? Let somebody shout hallelujah.
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 Are you ready? Your desk. Oh, yeah. Are you ready? Tell somebody, are you ready? Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. ability that can never be.
Eloni Maro, Afiki Shama, Oya, 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 Mako, Oju Norio, Mulo. Eloni Maro,
once again, everyone.
Oh,
Shall we give the Lord 7 thanksgiving? Hallelujah. Shall we go?
Hallelujah.
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 Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I welcome you to service this morning. The Lord bless every one of us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
This month of May still remains our month of great mercy, and the scriptural text is Psalm 145, verse number 8. I stand upon that word, I decree over you and I. The remaining days this month and beyond, we shall enjoy great mercy of God in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We shall richly enjoy the great mercy of God in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We shall richly enjoy the great mercy of God in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Isaiah 31, verse 5. Isaiah chapter number 31, verse 5, I read, as bought by flight, so will the Lord of hosts defend Jerusalem. Defending also, he will deliver it, and passing over, he will preserve it. That Jerusalem represents you and I. And the Lord said, as bought by flight, the Lord said, he will deliver you and I. In delivering, the Lord will defend us. And in defending, the Lord will also preserve you and I. I pray for you this morning as I stand upon this wall. I prophesy over you and I, our family members, home and abroad, all that we represent, that by the power of this word, the Lord will defend you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Lord will defend your work in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. The Lord will defend your health in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. The Lord will defend your home in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. The Lord will defend your marriage in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. The Lord will defend your children in Jesus' name.
Amen.
All that pertains to you and I, the Lord will defend us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Clan prayer center, Lekki, from the altar to the pew. The Lord will defend us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Every family represented on this mountain, home and abroad, our friends and family members streaming along with us, the Lord will defend us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Lord will defend us in Jesus'
Amen.
Name.
Amen.
The Lord will defend us in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. In defending, the Lord God Almighty will deliver us in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. From every strange agenda, you and I shall be delivered in Jesus' name.
Amen.
From every works of darkness, the Lord will deliver us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Whatever it is that does not glorify God, from that thing, the Lord will deliver you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
From manipulation, the Lord will deliver you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
From every dream attack, the Lord will deliver you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I decree in the name of Jesus Christ that in all areas of life that you need deliverance, the Lord will deliver you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Every career that is strengthened, I join my faith with yours, the Lord will deliver your career in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Businesses that are strengthened, I decree the name of Jesus, the Lord will deliver your business in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. The Lord will deliver your finances in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. That project, I pray, the Lord will deliver that project in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Lord will deliver you and I in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Bible said in preserving, in defending, the Lord will preserve. Amen. I pray that you and I, all that pertains to us, the Lord God Almighty will preserve us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Lord will preserve us in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. The Lord will preserve us in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. The Lord will preserve us in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. The Lord will preserve us in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. The Lord will preserve you and I in Jesus' name.
Amen.
All that pertains to us, the Lord will preserve it.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
This season is our season of turnaround.
Yes, Lord.
Isaiah 60. Isaiah 60, verse 1 and 2 says, you and I shall arise and shine. For our light has come and the glory of God has risen upon you and I. I pray for you this morning. I pray for myself that whatever it is preventing our shining, let the Lord remove it this morning in Jesus'
Amen.
Name.
Amen.
Anything at all that the enemy has assigned to prevent you and I from shining, even our family members, our spouses, our children, I decree by the mercy of God, let that thing be removed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let it be removed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let it be removed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let it be removed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Anything that the enemy has assigned to prevent you and I from moving forward in the dream, in the physical realm, I command, let it be removed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let it be removed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let it be removed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Whatever it is that the enemy has assigned, the powers of darkness has assigned to prevent you and I from rising in this season, I decree, let that thing be removed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be removed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be removed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Whatever it is that the enemy has assigned to hinder you and I from experiencing turnaround, I join my faith with yours. Let it be removed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be removed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be removed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let those things be removed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Anything that the enemy has put in place to prevent you and I
from experiencing the goodness of God, even in this season, in this time. I join my faith with yours for our family members home and abroad. Let that thing be removed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be removed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be removed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Whatever it is that is attacking and doing well in life. Today, this morning, by the mercy of God, by corporate grace and anointing, as I join my faith with you, anything at all, attacking and doing well in life, let that thing expire now in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Expire now in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Expire now in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Expire now in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Expire now in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. I pray for that sister, your name is Comfort. But there's nothing that answers those comfort land about you. I decree over you and anything at all, bringing discomfort into your life, as every one of us also say amen. Let that thing be removed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Anything responsible for discomfort, even though your name is Comfort, but you know that nothing about you speaks comfort. Whatever it is that is bringing discomfort, by the mercy of God right now, let it be removed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be removed in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Be removed in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Begin to enjoy the comfort of God.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Begin to enjoy the honor of God.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Begin to enjoy the glory of God.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Your name is Joy, but nothing answers to joy land about you. I pray for you this morning. Whatever it is that the enemy has assigned to disturb your joy and your gladness, let that thing be removed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let it be removed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let it be removed in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. From this moment, henceforth, you will have joy.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Your joy shall be full.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The name of God shall be glorified.
Amen.
You and I will do well.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Any garment that the enemy has put upon you in the dream, waiting to manifest in the physical realm, I join my faith with yours.
Yes.
Let the fire of the Holy Ghost consume those garments in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let those evil garments be roasted by fire.
Amen.
Let them be roasted by fire.
Amen.
Be roasted by fire.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Any ungodly covenant that the enemy is standing on, today, this morning, Isaiah 28, verse 18, I command those covenants break in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Break in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Break in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Break in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Any agreement that does not support and lift it.
Yes.
Today, by the mercy of God right now, let that agreement be annulled in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let it be cancelled in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Let it be aborted.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. I pray again, every wicked agenda, according to Job chapter number 5, verses 12 and 13, the Bible said he disappointed in the devices of the crafty, so that their hands cannot perform their wicked enterprise. Every wicked agenda from the pit of hell assigned against you and I. Psalm number 2, verse 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yes.
Say, why do the heavy rage and the people imagine in vain? Say, the kings of the hand and the princes thereof, they stand themselves together against God and against his anointed. I join my faith with yours this morning. Every wicked agenda, every rage of hell concerning you and I, concerning the church of God, concerning Clan Prayer Center, let it. Let that agenda be aborted now in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let it be aborted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let it be aborted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be aborted in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. The agenda of Haman concerning Mordecai was aborted. I pray for you and I with serious amen, with a loud amen. Every wicked agenda being orchestrated in the spirit realm, waiting to manifest in the physical realm concerning you and I, let it be aborted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be aborted in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Be aborted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In Acts of Apostles chapter number 23, the 40 guys, the Bible said they band themselves together and they swore an oath to kill Apostle Paul. But their agenda was nipping the ball, their agenda was aborted. I pray for you and I, any gang up from the pit of hell that has been covenanted to bring wicked agenda your way, my way, the way the Lord aborts those ones in Acts 23, let that wicked agenda concerning you and I, let it be aborted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be aborted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be aborted in Jesus'
Amen.
Name.
Amen.
Be aborted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The enemy will wait in vain.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
In Acts 27, after landing on the island of Patmos, the Bible said, a viper wound itself around the hand of Paul, and the barbarians were watching. They wanted to see what would become the end of Apostle Paul. But the Bible said he shook the snake into fire, and nothing, no harm came near him. I pray for you this morning. I pray for our family members, home and abroad. No harm will come near us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
No harm will come near us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
No harm will come near us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
No harm will come near us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
If the enemy is waiting to see what will become of you and I, they shall wait in vain in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Your God, my God, will shock the enemy in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Our joy shall be full.
Amen.
The name of God alone shall be glorified.
Amen.
So shall it be.
Amen.
The name of God the Father.
Amen.
In the name of God the Son.
Amen.
In the name of God the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I pray for you and I,
Amen.
That in our body we shall enjoy good health in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Jeremiah Isaiah 17:14 says, heal me, O Lord, and I shall be healed. Save me, O Lord, and I shall be saved, for thou art my praise. I pray for you and I. Let the power of God for healing rest upon us, home and abroad, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let there be healing in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let there be healing in Jesus'
name.
Amen. Let there be healing in Jesus'
name. Amen.
I pray for that brother with a pain on his toe, the right leg. I decree, let that pain disappear now in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Let it fade away in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let our joy be full.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Any pain in the breast, any growth, any lump, I join my faith with yours this morning. You shall see them no more in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. You shall see them no more in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Every token of the Egyptians, every load of the Egyptians, Exodus 14:13. Exodus 14:13 says, the Egyptians that you saw, you shall see them no more. I stand upon that wall. Anything that represents the load of Egypt, that represents affliction in the body, that represents any growth in the body,
yes.
I join my faith with every one of us, home and abroad.
Yes.
You shall see them no more in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You shall see them no more in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. You shall see them no more in Jesus'
Amen.
Name.
Amen.
I want you to place your hand wherever that pain may be. I want you to place your hand wherever that evil growth may be. I decree in the name of Jesus Christ,
yes,
you shall see it no more in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You shall see it no more in the name of
Amen.
Jesus. That woman, no stomach pain again in Jesus' name.
Amen.
No stomach pain again in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. That flow, unceasing flow of blood, this morning the Lord shut the tap in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That tap is shut now in the name of
Amen.
Jesus. That tap is shut now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That severe waist pain, I decree in the name of Jesus, let that pain disappear now in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Let that pain disappear now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let it disappear now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every ungodly neck pain, I pray, let the pain in the neck, let the arrow fire into the neck, fire into the back. Let it jump out now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every pain in your spine, let strangers in that area jump out and fade away in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let it jump out and fade away in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You and I, we are healed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We are healed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Join me as we sing this song that will pronounce healing.
Amen.
Jehovah Rapha is the Lord.
Jehovah Rapha is the Lord.
Jehovah Rapha
is the Lord. Is the Lord that healed me.
Jehovah Rapha
is the Lord.
Jehovah Rapha
is the Lord.
Jehovah Rapha
is the Lord. Is the Lord that healeth.
One more time.
Oh, Jehovah Rapha
is the Lord.
Jehovah Rapha
is the Lord. Strange cough, let it disappear in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every virus responsible for that cough, let it die now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It is well with you and I.
Amen.
Let every blood pressure that needed adjustment, the one that is low, the one that is too high, I join my faith with every one of us, woman abroad. Let that blood pressure be adjusted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let it be adjusted in Jesus'
name.
Amen. Be adjusted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be adjusted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be adjusted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be adjusted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be adjusted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be adjusted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Pray for that individual celebrating birthday today. Today is your birthday. The Lord said, I should tell you that you shall be visited in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Lord will said you will understand. Said he will make it up to you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord said you will understand. He said he will make it up to you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And I have a word for you in 2 Kings chapter number 8. That widow that was asked to leave by the prophet of God as a result of famine. By the time she returned back, the Bible said all her property, all her land has been taken over. And she went to the king to place a demand. Lo and behold, the Lord heard that as dead. As she went to the king Gehazi, the servant of the prophet was there, and Gehazi was recounting the exploit of the prophet, and all of a sudden this woman came in. Gehazi said to the king, King, this is the woman that the man of God brought a child back to life, and the king commanded restoration,
yes,
even with interest, because the Lord said he will make it up to you.
Amen.
I decree, let there be restoration in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Restoration with interest, receive
Amen.
It in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Your joy shall be full.
Amen.
The name of God alone shall be glorified.
Amen.
That help from abroad, receive it now in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It is well with you and I.
Amen.
So shall it be. Amen. In the name of God the Father, Amen. In the name of God the Son, Amen. In the name of God the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. In Jesus' name. Shall we put our hands together for the Lord? God bless us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
How are we doing this morning, George?
From grace to greater grace.
I pray for you and I, because we have confessed with our mouth, that shall continually be our testimony in Jesus' name.
Amen.
God will move you and I from grace to greater grace in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I bring you and I greeting from our Father in the Lord. Put your hands together for our parents in the Lord. Pastor Wole Oladio, our mother in the Lord. Pastor Mrs. Bukola Oladio, Daddy and Mommy, pray for us. And they pray for us that the remaining days this month, you and I shall be visited in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We shall be visited with the presence of God and with miracles. In the name of Jesus,
Amen.
Our joy shall be full.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
We love the Lord has a rich menu for us this morning. Quickly, we're going to take our hymn. Then we flow into the agenda of God for today. Our hymn. But what a friend we have in Jesus. That's the hymn. What a friend we have in Jesus. To every one of us.
Amen.
His name alone shall be glorified.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Holy Spirit, as we go into your word, breathe upon your word in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let your word bring solace away in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let your word bring succor in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let your word bring healing in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let your word edify us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let your word bring successes away in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
put your words in my mouth in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Prepare the heart of your children to receive your word.
Amen.
Let your word benefit everyone.
Amen.
Let your word mix with faith in our hearts.
Amen.
Thank you, Heavenly Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Jesus mighty name, we pray.
Amen. 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 In Jesus' name, said to
praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
I said last week when I was ministering at Sunday service that every spiritual information needs to be systematically put in place. Every revelation from the Word of God needs to be systematically formatted so that it can bring dividends your way and my way. When spiritual truths and information are scattered, it doesn't deliver mileage. It doesn't deliver as much mileage that it should deliver. I remember I said that every structure is systematically put in place. When a building is about to be constructed, the foundation will be put in place. From the foundation, you see iron rods put in place. From there, you see the block work begin to be put in place. And till it gets to the roofing, even till finishing touches, praise God.
Hallelujah.
Systematically put in place. So the same way with spiritual truth and information. And so we are continuing in that format, we are continuing in that line this morning. So we want to look at the message titled, My Cutting Edge and My Opportunity. My Cutting Edge and My Opportunity. I decree and I pray for you and I that this message will bring great blessings your way and my way in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
1 Corinthians chapter number 1 verse 24. 1 Corinthians 1:24 says, But unto them which are called, both Jews and Greek, Christ the power of God and the wisdom of God. Now in this context of the scripture, Jesus Christ is exemplified as the power of God. He's also exemplified as the wisdom of God. It means that every child of God must learn to operate in that two areas. Every child of God must learn to operate in those two formats. Every child of God must operate in the power of God. Every child of God must operate in the wisdom of God. Power without wisdom will not deliver mileage. Wisdom without spiritual power will not deliver mileage. But as we combine these two, exemplified by Jesus Christ, the power and the wisdom of God, blessings comes our way, testimonies comes our way,
amen.
Mileage comes our way. I pray that Christ, the wisdom of God and the power of God will be manifested in your life and in my life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
This wisdom of God, this power of God will manifest in our life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I was preaching on Thursday and I was talking about opportunities. The Lord led me to begin to talk about opportunities on Thursday. It was while dwelling on this message of opportunity that the Lord introduced this dimension to the message today. Remember Jeremiah 29 verses 11 and 12. It's a popular scripture that we know so well, but it's important that we just remind ourselves of this scripture. Jeremiah 29, 11, 12. For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, saith the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. Verse 12, then shall ye call upon me, and ye shall go and pray unto me, and I will hearken unto you. The Lord said he knows the plan that he has towards you and I, plans of good and not of evil, and to give us every goodness that we desire. The Lord went further by saying that when we call unto him, he will answer us and hearken to us. I pray for you this morning that as we call unto the Most High God, even in prayer, the Lord will answer us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Our joy shall be full in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
A man may have skill, but such a man may not enjoy favor. And there are plenty of people that are skillful, talented, but because favor is not added to their skill, they become vagabond, and so their skill is nothing to write home about. God is the only one that can promote. I pray your skill, my skill, your talent, my talent, our cutting edge
The Lord will add favor to it this morning in Jesus'
Amen.
Name.
Amen.
The favor of God will be added to it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The favor of God is the flavor that dispenses sweet aroma, that dispenses sweet influences from the talent and the skills that we carry. And so it is important that we carry the favor of God. I pray for you this morning that more than ever before, the favor of God will be a part and parcel of our life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I said it on Thursday that life is full of opportunities. I said it that even more so in this season, so much opportunity abounds. And I remember I said that as children of the Most High God, even in this season, in this time, we are not permitted to miss out on beneficial opportunity. I pray for you that even in this season, you and I will not miss out on beneficial opportunities in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Bible said that even in the time of famine, it was in that same time that Isaac sowed and reaped 100% when it was impossible. I pray for you this morning. I also pray for myself that even in this time, we shall reap 100% in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We shall reap 100% in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Opportunity is important. I said, a single opportunity can change a situation. A single opportunity can change the narration. It can change the narrative of a man for life. Why also? The loss of an opportunity can make a man very miserable. Opportunities come. And it is very good and godly when we maximize such opportunities. But it can be very terrible when we miss out on opportunities. I pray for you this morning. I pray for myself. You and I will not miss out on opportunity in Jesus' name.
Amen.
A man walked up to me. I told him, I looked at him. I said, Oga, you need to pray very well for your life to make meaning. And I ran him through some prayers. And lo and behold, he had a revelation. He returned back with a revelation. And he said to me, he said, Pastor, he said, he used to be a footballer. He said, he used to be a footballer. And he said, he narrowly missed out on opportunity to be a global force to be reckoned with. And he mentioned one of his teammates. The teammate played for our nation, Nigeria. The teammate had a successful professional career abroad. One of the half-caste footballers that played for our nation, Nigeria. I don't want to mention the name. He's an half-caste. Yeah. Played for our nation, Nigeria. Yeah. He said that's his teammate. He said they were bunkmates in camp. And as at the time he was telling me this, even this teammate has retired from professional football. What happened to him? He had a revelation and he saw himself, the jersey, the boots, the hose, all of the paraphernalia of playing football, he saw it locked up in an ancient room. And I prayed for him. I said to him that the enemy meant it for evil, but God has a creative way of turning things around. God bless you, keep up. God has a creative way of turning things around. And the enemy thought they have ended his career, but God opened another chapter for him, even in that same field. And so he had an opportunity, he had a contract with the state government to be training youth in soccer. I pray for you this morning. If you have missed out on opportunity before, the mercy of God will bring those opportunities back today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The mercy of God will bring back those opportunities today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
A young lady walked up to me, said, Pastor, guess my age. I said, I can't guess your age. Said, Pastor, I am 42 years of age. This is about five or six years ago now. She was 42 years of age then. And she said to me, it was a narrative of situations that are not palatable. Her narration was a narrative of stories that touched the heart. And she said to me that the father struggled to train them in school. Their father, a professor in one of the foremost first generation university. They live all their life in the university campus, the primary school, in the university, the secondary, and even the university education. She said to me that the father labored as a lecturer for 27 years. All of a sudden, opportunity came. An opportunity came to his home state. And so they began to look for someone that qualified. After 27 years of holding the chalk in the classroom, they located his father, being a professor, and also he is a professor in that choosing field. And they picked him, and he was chosen as a director general of a federal parastata. And the lady said to me that 27 years of pain, 27 years of poverty, 27 years of lack turned over immediately. The man was given two official cars, a Pajero Jeep. Then it was the era of Turaya. He gave the man a Turaya police escort and everything. But lo and behold, the man died just 3 months on that job. They put something on his chair, he sat on it, and he died. The lady was so bitter. She was bitter with society, bitter with God. I needed to pray with her. I needed to nurture her back to loving God again. And she said to me that it would have been better that the opportunity did not come. He said, Pastor, for 3 months, they knew blessings. He said, for 3 months, it was a massive 360 degree turnaround. They said, all of a sudden, as the thing came, the thing disappeared. Now, those are the powers called anti-testimony, opportunity powers. They are the powers that kill good things at infancy. They still exist today. They know when opportunities are coming. They know how to block goodly and godly opportunity. But I pray for you this morning, I pray for myself, that henceforth, you and I, we shall not miss out on beneficial opportunity in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We shall not miss out on beneficial opportunities in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That is not the route I am going this morning. I am going towards another route. I want us to look at the area of our cutting edge. You may also call it your unique selling proposition. What does this thing represent? Let me tell us what opportunity represents. Opportunity is a set of circumstances that makes it possible to do something new, that makes it possible to achieve something new, that makes it possible for a man to achieve something lofty, something of great value. A set of circumstances that makes it possible for a man to do something new. This set of circumstances is orchestrated by God. And so it will now be an aberration when God has put situations and circumstances in place for you and I so that we can maximize it. It will not be an aberration when our cutting edge has been tampered with. It will not be an aberration when our axe head has become missing. It will not be an aberration when our axe head has become blunt. I pray for you this morning. I pray for myself. Every missing axe head, every missing cutting edge, the one that has been tampered with, that is making you to miss out on opportunities, this morning they shall be recovered in Jesus' name.
Amen.
As they are recovered, they shall be restored in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. And so your axe head is your cutting edge. Your axe head is your unique selling proposition. It is that thing that makes you different from others. It is that thing that it is the excellency of God inside of you. It is the portion of the glory of God that you share. It is that thing that God has put inside of you to magnetize all the blessings and goodness that you desire. I pray for you this morning. I pray for myself that your cutting edge, my cutting edge, your accent, my accent, will not be tampered with in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It will not be tampered with in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It will not be tampered with in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In 2 Kings chapter number 6, verse 1 to 7, is a popular scripture that we know. The son of the prophet, the Bible said, they suddenly discovered an opportunity to enlarge. They suddenly discovered that the place that they were is too narrow, is too limited for them. And so they decided to expand their frontiers. They decided to manifest Isaiah 54, 2 and 3 to lengthen their course and to extend their stakes. And so to do that, they saw the opportunity. To maximize that opportunity, they needed a axe. And the Bible said they went to borrow an axe to be deployed in cutting beams to extend their tabernacle and their habitation. But in the process of felling the beams, they borrowed axe head, fell into the water. But thank God for the presence of God. The presence of God represented by the prophetic father they carried along. The axe head was recovered. The Lord said to me, that many Christians go about with missing axe head. So that's the reason why many cannot maximize opportunity. I pray for you this morning. I pray for myself. Every axe head that has been missing, unknown to you,
this morning they shall be restored in Jesus'
Amen.
Name.
Amen.
The access shall be restored in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Whatever we do in life, we must carry the presence of God with us. And so it is important, you must be sure of this, that the presence of God, the presence of the Holy Spirit is with you. I pray that you and I, we shall not miss out on the presence of God in Jesus' name.
Amen.
No matter your academic laurel, no matter your skills and talent, if God does not breathe upon it, it won't work out. It won't manifest. It won't see the light of the day. I pray for you this morning. I pray for myself that upon what you and I carry, the Lord will breathe upon it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
What is your accent? What does it represent? What does it mean? Your accent means your achievement. Your accent means your cutting edge. In your area of versatility, your accent is your charisma, your peculiar charisma, that thing that is peculiar to you alone. If it is lost, it will create a major gulf, a major vacuum in the life of a man. I pray for you this morning. I pray for myself. Your charisma, my charisma, we shall not lose it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Your accent is your unique talent, a talent that is so unique to you. Your accent is your skill. Your accent is your gift. Your accent is also your health. When you enjoy good health, you can maximize opportunity. A man that is in the hospital, the only prayer he will be praying for is healing. He won't even be shopping for opportunity. So I pray again, just as you have prayed earlier for healing, let your healing come in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Your accent could be a precious thing. Your accent is your glory. Your accent is your anointing. Your accent is your grace, your peculiar grace. Your accent is your means of success in life. Your accent is the power to make achievement, the power to make it, the power to achieve and to succeed in life. Your accent can be a platform. Your accent can be a resources for your next level. Your accent is your relevance. Your accent is your establishment. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ, you and I, we shall not lose our relevance in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We shall not lose our relevance in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Your accent is your advancement. Your accent is your enthronement. I pray we won't lose our enthronement and our advancement in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In John chapter number 2, verse 11, an opportunity came for our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank God he didn't miss out on that opportunity. If he has missed out on that opportunity, peradventure we will be here today. It was at the wedding of Cana in Galilee. And all of a sudden, a lack occurred. A depletion set in. And it was an opportunity for our Lord Jesus Christ to manifest his deity, to manifest his 100% God and 100% man nature. And so, thank God he didn't miss out on that opportunity. The mother of our Lord Jesus Christ had an understanding. And so she threw the opportunity at our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank God, our Lord Jesus Christ manifested what glory. And the Bible said in verse 12, it was when he manifested glory that his disciples believed in him. Your cutting edge is your glory. You must manifest glory. I pray for you this morning. I pray for myself. You and I will manifest glory in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. We shall manifest glory in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. It was so compelling. They were following our Lord Jesus Christ. They were still skeptical. But it was when he manifested. In fact, that was the first miracle. It was when they saw it. That they went from this business with water. How come he turned to wine? How come? So much so that the chairman of the occasion testified to the uniqueness of that wine. They saw it with their two eyes. And so the Bible said they believed Jesus Christ, and our Lord Jesus Christ manifested glory. He keyed into the opportunity. He didn't miss out on that opportunity. And so the disciples knew that this is actually a deity. This is actually a God. And so they were resolute in following him. I pray for you this morning. I pray for myself. That in the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, you and I, we shall not miss out on opportunity in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We shall not miss out on opportunity in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Remember, it is only God that gives results for our effort. And it is only God that makes our effort to endure. I pray, your effort, my effort, the Lord will make it turn to result in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Our result will also endure in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So the Lord said to me that the accent of many have been lost. Therefore, many cannot maximize opportunity that comes their way. And so this morning we want to look unto God for our asset to be restored. I pray that your asset, my asset, shall be restored in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Every opportunity that comes our way after now, we shall begin to maximize it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
As we maximize this opportunity, great dividends shall be delivered to us in Jesus'
Amen.
Name.
Amen.
Great dividends shall be delivered to us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
What will be the cause of lost heart? Number one is sin. Isaiah 30 verse 1 say the heart sin to sin. If you have been hardening sin to sin, the accent could be lost. I pray that the Lord will forgive all sins in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Another reason that could result into loss of accent is manipulative mistakes and error. I pray for you this morning. I pray for myself. You and I will not go into manipulative mistakes and error in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Another thing that could make an accent to be tampered with. Another thing that could make glory to become incapable is laziness and slothfulness. Proverbs 13 verse 4 said the soul of the sluggard desireth and hath nothing, but the soul of the diligent shall be made fat. So if you are lazy and slothful, opportunity will elude you. I pray for you this morning that every spirit of laziness and slothfulness, even the life of our children, let it fade away in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Number four that will result into loss of accent is acidic tongue and careless talk. Ecclesiastes 5:6 says, suffer not your mouth to cause thy flesh to sin, neither say thou before the angel that it was an error. Wherefore should God be angry at thy voice and destroy the work of your hand? You can see how powerful the words of our mouth is. He says so that you won't say before the God, the angel, that it is a mistake. No. No. Acidic tongue and careless talk could result into loss of accent. Many, they have used their tongue to throw away their accent. I pray for you this morning. If that describes you, the mercy of God will prevail. The accent will be restored back in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lack of wisdom. Ecclesiastes 9:16, 16 to 18. Lack of wisdom will result into loss of accent. Today, the Lord will behave as God and restore it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Insufficient knowledge. That is why we always say that you must build capacity. We believe in acquiring knowledge. We believe in training and retraining ourselves. And so you must be a professor in your chosen field. You must be a professor in your chosen field. I was saying to my wife some few days ago, yes. I said if they award professor in deliverance, I said I should be a professor. Praise the Lord.
We said to God,
even a emeritus professor, praise God.
Hallelujah.
And so you must be a professor in your chosen field. You must know what you do like the palm of your hand. It is so important. You must know at every point in time world best practices in what you do. I pray that the Lord God Almighty will make you and I more proficient in what we do in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So you must acquire knowledge. You must build capacity. Remember 1 Corinthians 1:24. Christ the wisdom of God. Christ the power of God. Acquiring knowledge is the aspect of wisdom. The Lord will help you and I in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Another thing that could result into loss of access is demonic dreams. I pray if the enemy has been tormenting you through dreams, they've been stealing things from you, you've been experiencing robbery and theft in your dream this morning. Every attack to your dream, the Lord will turn into victory for you and I in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So the attack expires in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The attack expires in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Another thing that will result into loss of access, thereby making a man to miss out on opportunity, is distraction. 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 I pray you and I will not be distracted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We shall not be distracted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Another thing that will result is wrong habits and character deficiency. It is important that you and I must be top-notch in our character. The Lord God Almighty will help us to do away with pride, to do away with bitterness, to do away with a lot of wrong habits in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Another thing that will cause loss of access is refusal to follow godly principles, kingdom principles, principles of tithing and offering, principles of seed time and harvest time. Let me say this. If an armed robber, because the Bible said in Genesis 8, 21 or 22, that seed time and harvest time will not fail.
Yeah.
If an armed robber plants, it will grow. Mm. If an armed robber plants something, it will grow. If an armed robber seed, he will have
an increase upon his seed. Why? Because it is a principle. Because that man has obeyed a principle. Praise God. I remember that story in the book of in the Old Testament when the children of Israel went to war. The Bible said the battle was so fierce, and that king, the king, noticed that he must do something drastic. Yes. He had an understanding of sacrifice. Mm. Your seed is your sacrifice. Yes. And what did he do? The Bible said he took his son, even the first son that should be and here, that should reign after him, and sacrifice unto the God of Israel. And God looked the other way. Mm. The man had victory. Praise God. That is the power of sacrifice. Mm. Kingdom principle. You must not listen to all this worldly whatever. Please, it is important. Seed time and harvest time. Your seed is a sacrifice. If it doesn't die, it won't come up. And so when you give, it is I am seeding. It dies, it leaves your hand, it died, and it returns back with multiple harvests. I pray this shall be our experiences in Jesus' name. This shall be our experiences in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Disobedience to godly instruction and authority can lead to loss of access. I pray that you and I will not lose our access in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now, what are the consequences? What are the consequences? You know, I said that when an access is missing, opportunity will elude a man. Mm. So what are the consequences? When the access is no more there, when the access has been lost, when glory has become a carbon, what is the consequence? Number one, it results into much activity but little productivity. The person will be walking like an elephant. They will be eating like an ant. Much activity but little productivity. I pray if this has been your experience, the Lord will reverse it this morning in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Another consequence is that there will be motion but little movement. It appears as if the man is making motion, but he's just marking time on the same spot. If this has been your experiences also, the Lord will reverse it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Much effort with little results. Much effort with little result. He said, you have sown in much, but you have brought in little. He said, because I have made it to put it in back with holes. If you have been putting resources in back with holes, the Lord God Almighty will reverse that trend this morning in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Lord will reverse it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Will the Lord reverse it in Jesus' name?
Amen.
What are the consequences? With the same skill, you no longer generate the same result like you used to do. If this describes you, the Lord will reverse it this morning in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now, you notice that your sphere of influence is dwindling so fast. Your sphere of influence is dwindling so fast. The Lord God Almighty is one of the consequences of a missing asset. It shows that something is wrong, something is missing concerning your cutting edge. The Lord God Almighty will reverse that trend in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You notice that where they once celebrate you, you are now being tolerated. Something is wrong. The missing asset has been tampered with. This ugly trend, the Lord will reverse it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It shall be reversed in Jesus'
Amen.
Name.
Amen.
It shall be reversed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You also notice that instead of commendations, your effort is attracting condemnation. Instead of commendation, your effort is now attracting condemnation. If this describes what you do, if this describes your experiences, the Lord will behave as God. No more condemnation in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
But there shall be commendations in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. You notice that what used to work for you is no longer working for you again. You need to pray very well. The Lord God Almighty will restore every missing accent in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Or you also notice that you have lost your voice. Where you were once an authority, where you used to be an authority, your voice no more counts in that sphere. Today I pray the Lord God Almighty will behave as God and reverse that trend in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Lord will reverse that trend in Jesus'
Amen.
Name.
Amen.
Beloved, we want to take a moment and pray. I want us to use quality time this morning, like 10 minutes to pray very well. But I want to mention some cases. If all of these cases describes you, beloved, be ready to pray this morning. Why will you pray? So that the Lord will put an end to this ugly trend. So that every opportunity in this season, in this time, you and I will begin to maximize it. So that opportunity will not elude you and I again. So that you will be invited into new things. So that you will be called into new things. The Lord said to me that a lot of us, they will hand over new businesses to you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And it will prosper in our hands in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Number one, if good opportunities slip through your hand, be ready to pray as you begin to pray. You are a victim of what we called a slippery breakthrough. Be ready to pray. You notice that you hold opportunity by the tail instead of the head. And so it fills you out in your hand be ready to pray as you begin to pray. You notice that you have gained nothing from every best opportunity that have come your way. Golden opportunities that have come your way, you've not been able to maximize it. Please pray very well as you begin to pray. Upon adventure, it happened to your father. He had wonderful opportunities in life, but he messed all of them up, and it has become a gem in your family. It is happening to sons in your family, and you don't want it to happen to you. The Lord will behave as God and put an end to that ugly pattern in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You notice that there are certain powers. They scatter when you gather. They make opportunities elude you. Please pray very well as you begin to pray. The Lord will reverse this trend in Jesus' name.
Amen.
This ugly trend shall be reversed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You are a man or you are a woman. You witness filtering away of golden opportunities. Be ready to pray as you begin to pray. You observe that there are wicked powers that swallow your opportunities. Be ready to pray as you begin to pray. You also notice that opportunity wasters and emptiers are in operation. When you have opportunities that seem so good, a particular dream will come, and all of a sudden, that blessing will go away. Someone sent a mail to me. Another one sent a message to me via a Facebook Messenger, and it was similar. And they both said to me that when they have goodly opportunities, a particular dream will come. I'm talking about 2 or 3 days ago now. A particular dream will come that will put an end to this opportunity. I pray for you this morning, because Jeremiah 29:11 says, the thought that the Lord has for you and I are thought of good and not of evil. All of those ugly trends, the Lord reverse it this morning in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It is reversed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It is reversed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You are viewing this message abroad. You've been online. You've been in the corridor of power, but you are unable to harness any gain from it. Pray very well. The Lord God Almighty is a God of second chance.
Amen.
The Lord will bring the second chance your way in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You discover the opportunities that made your colleagues prosper. That opportunity has also made you worse off. Pray very well as you begin to pray. You discover that opportunities are always withdrawn when it gets to your turn. Beneficial opportunities are always withdrawn when it gets to your turn. Pray very well as you begin to pray. You notice that there are ancestral gates that locked up people in your family. Please pray very well. If you have ever had a dream when you've seen yourself or your siblings being locked up in a place, pray very well. The Lord God Almighty will command victory for you this morning in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Lord will command victory for you this morning in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. You notice that your family name constantly withdraw good things from you, good opportunities from you. Please pray very well and call for counseling. It is not supposed to be so. The Lord will reverse it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Lord will reverse it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You notice that each time you are to benefit from an opportunity, some powers will provoke you and you will be disqualified. Pray very well as you begin to pray. The Lord will give you victory in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Beloved, I can go on and on and on and on and on, and we won't leave here this morning. But because I want us to devote some quality time to prayer, I want to stop on those cases now. But you know that, Pastor, I want goodly and godly opportunities to come my way. And I also want to maximize this opportunity. And I want this opportunity to deliver dividends into my hand. Join me as we begin to pray. The Lord will answer us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Because it is the mandate of God for this season. He said to me, he said, many access has been lost. That's why opportunities are being missed. And the Lord God Almighty will behave as God this morning. He will restore your access and my access in Jesus' name.
Amen.
For some, it could be political access that is missing. For some, it could be business acumen access. For some, it could be career access. For some, it could be ministerial access. It could be academic access. I pray, but in all areas, any access that has been missing, the Lord will restore it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It could be creative access for those in creative industry. If your creative access has been missing, the Lord will behave as God and restore it back this morning in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Before we begin to pray, you are viewing online, you are not born again. It is important that you have a relationship with the Lord God Almighty. The one that can bring opportunities your way, the one that can restore your access. And so if you are viewing online, you want to be born again, you are tired of playing church or playing religion,
Please put your right hand on your chest and repeat after me. Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Come before you this morning.
I come before you this morning.
The scripture says.
With the heart.
The man believes. And with the mouth. Confession is made. I believe that you are my Lord. You died for me. You rose again on the third day. For my justification.
You
are seated at the right hand of God. Interceding for me. I confess with my mouth.
I confess my mouth this morning.
That I am born again. I accept you, Jesus. As my Lord and Savior. I am born again today. I will not go back to the world. Holy Spirit. Help me. Uphold my feet. In the name of Jesus. Say amen. Congratulations.
Hallelujah.
My hands together for you. If you have repeated that prayer after me, congratulations, you are born again.
Amen.
The full number is on the screen. The reason is that I and my team members can uphold you in prayer so that you can send your prayer request to us or support. So that if you need support, you can send to us. You're going to do an SMS to that phone number, capital Yes to Jesus, so that we can follow through with you. Quickly do that now. Take your phone. If you have said that prayers with me, capital Yes to Jesus, the Lord God Almighty, we uphold you and I. In the name of Jesus
Christ. Amen.
We love, we want to pray now. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
We want to sing this song. The song is taken from Colossians chapter number 2, verses 9 and 10. Colossians 2, 9 and 10. It says, for ye are complete in him, who is the head of all principalities and powers. So the song is this, complete in him. I am complete. Let me rehearse it first. Complete in him. I am complete in him. It's not by works of righteousness, but by his grace alone. It's not by works of righteousness, but by his grace alone. So I am complete. Are we ready?
Yes.
Amen. Shall we go? Complete.
I am complete.
Show me mercy.
Even this morning.
In the name of Jesus.
Oh Lord, show me mercy. Even this morning. In the name of Jesus.
Over my talent,
over my skill,
over my know-how,
over my peculiar grace,
over my
glory.
Over my glory.
Let it be destroyed.
Let it be destroyed.
Stronghold of the enemy.
Stronghold of the enemy.
Over my access.
Over my access.
Be destroyed.
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 Be destroyed. Be destroyed.
Be destroyed.
Be destroyed. Be destroyed. Be destroyed. Be destroyed. Be destroyed. Be destroyed.
Be destroyed. Be destroyed. Be destroyed.
Be destroyed. Be destroyed. Be destroyed.
By the mercy and grace of God,
my access,
my access,
be recovered
now.
Open your mouth and
talk.
Locate me now by fire.
by my fire.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Send my opportunity.
My opportunity.
In the eastern hemisphere
of the world.
Hear the word of the
Lord.
Locate me now by fire.
Locate me now by fire.
In the
eastern
hemisphere of the world.
Locate
me now by fire.
Locate
me now by fire.
Locate
me now by fire. Locate me now by fire.
Locate
me now by fire.
Locate me now by fire.
Locate me now by fire. In Jesus' mighty name we are located.
Amen.
Send my opportunities.
My opportunities.
Beneficial opportunities.
Beneficial opportunities.
In the southern hemisphere.
In the southern hemisphere.
Hear the word of the Lord.
Hear the word of the Lord.
Locate me now by fire.
Locate me now by fire.
Locate
me now by fire.
All my opportunities.
Beneficial opportunities.
Opportunities.
In the southern hemisphere.
Locate
me now by fire.
In the southern hemisphere.
Locate me now by
fire. East and northern hemisphere.
Locate me now by fire.
Locate
me now
by fire.
Locate me now by fire.
Locate me now by fire.
Locate me now by fire.
Locate me now by fire.
Locate me now by fire.
Locate me now by fire.
Locate me now by fire.
Locate me now by fire.
Locate me now by fire.
Look at my fire.
Look at
my
fire.
Look at my fire. In the name of Jesus, I will pray. Say in the name of Jesus.
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 My opportunity.
My opportunity.
My opportunity.
My opportunity.
My opportunity.
My opportunity.
In the western hemisphere of the world.
Western hemisphere of the world.
Hear the word of the Lord.
Give me by fire.
Give me by fire.
Give me by fire.
Give me by fire.
My opportunities in the western hemisphere of the world.
Look at me by fire.
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 Open your mouth of
fire.
Look at my fire.
Look at
my fire.
Give me by fire.
Name of Joshua. From the western hemisphere, all my opportunities. Look at me by fire.
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 In the name of Jesus.
Look at me by fire.
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 In the name of Jesus.
Lift up your two hands. Say, oh Lord, my Father,
oh Lord, my Father,
on that matter,
on that matter,
concerning my access,
concerning my glory,
concerning my glory,
oh Lord, complete me.
Open your mouth and talk to
me.
Oh Lord,
on that matter, concerning
yes.
my access, oh Lord, complete me.
Oh
Lord, complete me.
In the name of Jesus.
Complete me, Lord.
Oh Lord, complete me,
Lord.
Oh Lord, complete me.
By your mercy,
complete me, Lord.
Complete me, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Complete me, Lord.
Complete me, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
The fullness of the Godhead bodily dwelleth in the Lord.
Pray. I'm seeking you. Begin to pray. Oh Lord, complete me.
Look at me.
The fullness
complete the Lord.
God in the name of Jesus.
Oh, my opportunities.
Western hemisphere.
Complete me, Lord.
Complete me, Lord.
Oh Lord, complete
me, Lord.
Complete me, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Complete me, Lord.
Complete me, Lord.
Oh Lord,
in the name of Jesus.
Oh Lord, complete
me, Lord.
Oh Lord, complete me.
In all areas of life,
all areas of
complete
me. Hold on,
hold on, hold
on, complete me.
Hold on, complete
me. Complete me.
Complete
me. Complete
me. Complete
me. Complete
me. Complete me.
Complete me. Complete me. Oh Lord,
complete us, O Lord.
Complete us, O Lord.
Complete us, O Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
So shall it be.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
God, I want us to continue. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Master.
Hallelujah.
It is well with you and I.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Put your hands together for the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord has answered our prayers in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Then I know the plans that I have towards you.
Yes.
The plan of good and not of evil. He said, and you will call upon me. Jeremiah 29, 11 and 12. He said, you will call upon me. I will hearken unto you. As we have called on God, the Lord has hearken unto you and I. The Lord has hearken unto us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Our joy shall be full.
Amen.
The name of God shall be glorified.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Blessing time, offering time.
Hallelujah.
Offering time, blessing time. It is time to give our offering. The account details will be on the screen. God bless you as you give
Amen.
Unto your God in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
2 Corinthians 9:10. 2 Corinthians chapter number 9, verse 10 says, it is God that gives you an seed. He giveth seed to the sower. He is also the one that blesses the seed. Praise God. And that thing that you have, that one in your custody, is a seed from God. The Lord gives it unto you. The Bible said in that first Corinthians, he said, what is it that a man has that he did not receive from heaven? Everything that you have, you receive from heaven. God gives the seed. And he said to bless that seed. As you give your offering this morning, as you give your tithe, even as you release those seed, the seed for recovery. Someone should sow that seed, seed of accident recovery, seed of manifestation, seed of opportunity location. Someone should actually do that. The Lord bless you as you sow that
Amen.
Seed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Join my faith with us. I want to pray now. Lord God Almighty, behold our offering,
yes,
behold our tithe.
Yes, Lord.
Behold, O Lord, our seed, accept it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You gave us this seed. Out of the much you've given us, We bring it this unto you. Accept it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Accept we the sower in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, I pray that every one of us all over the world, you bless our seed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The blessings of God that follows faithful giver, let it follow us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The blessings of God that follows faithful tither, let it follow us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The blessings of God that follows every seed that we sow, because we are a covenant keeping God. Father, keep your covenant with us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let our joy be full.
Amen.
Let your name alone be glorified.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Shall we take a moment now? Let's begin to make our transfer to that, to the account details on the screen. The Lord will bless you and I in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Begin to send in your offering. Begin to send in your tithe. We are closing in the next 2 minutes. Begin to send in your offering. Begin to send in your tithe. The Lord will accept it. The Lord will bless you and I. His name alone shall be glorified in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The name of God shall be glorified.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Opportunities will locate you and I.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
As they locate us, we shall maximize those opportunities.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Our joy shall be full.
Amen.
The name of God alone shall be glorified.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And I will go upward.
Amen.
And I will go forward.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I declare and I declare as we release our seed, the Lord will bless us. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Multiple fold.
Amen.
In return.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Massive increase.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord will bless us.
Amen.
No weapon fashioned against you and I shall prosper.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Every tongue that rises up against the judgment shall be condemned.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
As we give our seed, wasters will not come into our seed.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Your productive year, my productive year will not be wasted.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We need to say a loud amen to this prophetic prayer. I declare and I declare the horns of the wicked, every horns of the wicked that might have been assigned against you and I, against our access today, from this moment, those horns of the wicked, I cut them off in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I cut it off in Jesus'
Amen.
Name.
Amen.
I cut it off in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. I cut it off in Jesus'
Amen.
Name.
Amen.
I pray for you this morning. I pray for myself. Powers that specializes in wasting productive years. Anti-opportunity powers. Today, I decree and I declare, they will not waste our opportunity in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Your productive year, my productive year, will not be wasted in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Your productive year, my productive year, will not be wasted in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Powers that makes life difficult. Powers that scatter when a man gathers. Concerning you and I, concerning our harvest, the Lord destroy them in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Henceforth, when we gather, it shall not be scattered in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Henceforth, when you and I, when we gather, home and abroad, even in the spiritual realm, in the physical realm, when we gather, it shall not be scattered in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It shall not be scattered in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I pray every strong man in charge of Axe Air, in your father's house, in your mother's house, in your in-laws' family, every strong man that has been mandated to keep people's access in custody concerning you and I, because we have called on God this morning, those strong men, we bind them, we cast them out in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We bind them, we cast them out in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It is well with you and I.
Amen.
Raise an altar.
God,
an altar of manifestation.
Yes,
manifestation of access, recovery and restoration.
Amen.
In the name of God the Father,
Amen.
Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Raise an altar of opportunity. Goodly, beneficial, godly opportunities, more than ever before, to begin to locate you and I, home and abroad, our family, our spouses, our children, our ministry, our calling, clan, prayer, center, Lekki, in the name of God the Father,
Amen.
The Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
It is well with you and I.
Amen.
Upward ever, forward ever.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Psalm 97, verse 3 says, a fire went before the Lord, and destroys enemies round about. He suffers no man to do any wrong. In the book, the Kings were saying, touch no man, nothing that do my prophet no harm. Raise an altar, any regrouping, backlashing, it is aborted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
What the Lord has done for you and I shall be permanent.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You and I will testify.
Amen.
We are blessed.
Amen.
Go and prosper.
Amen.
We come back with testimony.
Amen.
We come back with joy and
gladness. Amen.
It is set.
Amen.
In the name of God the Father.
Amen.
The Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Jesus' mighty name. We pray.
Amen. 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 In Jesus' name.
Shall we set. Share the grace in fellowship one to grow?
May the grace
of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit
be with us now and forevermore. Amen.
Surely,
God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever.
Amen. Shall we take the clap and tell one, two, go?
Oh God, our plan we pray.
Your holy day,
your holy day, in our holy forever you are Lord. Revive us.
God bless us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Shalom.